Hello, my dear students. I welcome you all in video lecture number 2 of alternating current. Myself, Professor Dr. Prashant Vageshwar, Department of Physics, Mungsaji Maharaj Mahavidyalaya Dharwa. In video lecture number 1, we have discussed the review, what we have studied before the lockdown because of the pandemic disease, coronavirus. I hope you read it very well and you might be ready for the second lecture. And today I am going to deliver second lecture on application of AC voltage source to LR circuit. We see the fourth circuit, application of AC voltage source to LR circuit. So consider the LR circuit. This is inductor of inductance L, resistor of resistance R, connected in series with the source of alternating voltage. Suppose E is equals to E0 sin of omega t, or we write this thing in complex form, E0 e to the power j omega t. So as per the loop equation, the PD across this is EL, PD across this is ER. Okay, so what we write here, E, applied EMF, E, it should be equals to EL plus ER. ER plus EL. Okay. So, we know applied EMF in, you can say, complex form, we can write here E0. E to the power j omega t is equals to ER, that is actually IR, plus j omega L I. We know this thing. Now see, we applied here AC voltage source, so alternating current will flow, and this alternating current we want to find out. We have find out the alternating current in pure resistive circuit, then pure inductive circuit, pure capacitive circuit. We know the expressions for I for different circuits. Now today we have combined the two components, electrical components, inductor and resistor. So if you got these three first circuit, very easily you can write down about the fourth circuit. Okay, so as we want to find out the current, so you can take current common in the right hand side. So you write here R plus j omega L, it is equals to E0 e to the power j omega t. So finally, the current in this LR circuit, it should be equals to E0 e to the power j omega t divided by R plus j omega L. You can number the equation. This is suppose your first equation. This is your second equation. Very simple. Simple mathematics is there. You have to do this thing very carefully. Okay. Now in this equation, you look here, this is current. The numerator is the EMF voltage. So this denominator quantity, it should be what? Definitely it should be the resistance. Resistance of what? These two components. So you can say combined resistance. So let us we assume in this equation the denominator is known to be the complex impedance of the circuit. Complex impedance is suppose vector Z, and it is equals to R plus J omega L. Denominator, because this is, as I told you, current voltage, so definitely the denominator, what it is, it should be the combined resistance, and combined resistance is called as the impedance. And why this is called as the complex? Because it is consisting real and imaginary part. So this is the real part and this is the imaginary part. So this is suppose equation number second, this is equation number third. Okay. Now this is just mathematics. Anybody can do it if you listen. So anybody can do it. Very simple and very scoring. Now let Z be the magnitude of this complex impedance. Z be the magnitude of the complex impedance vector Z. So we try to find out the value of this Z. Okay, so for this we do some substitution. Yes, so to determine Z, that is the magnitude of vector Z, to determine Z of vector Z, we make some substitution. As R is suppose replaced by Z into cos of suppose phi, and omega L is suppose replaced by Z into sin phi. Okay, this is very important step in order to calculate the Z, magnitude of vector Z. Okay, let us assume this is equation number three is over. This is suppose fourth, this is suppose fifth. Okay, and in order to satisfy this substitution, let us draw here some triangle like this. It is very important. In most of the books you will not see this triangle, but because of drawing this triangle everything becomes easy. So let us assume this is phi, angle phi. This is front side, this is you can say adjacent side, and this is you can say hypotenuse. So let us, this is WL, this is suppose R, and definitely this is the base, this is the height. So what will be the hypotenuse? Hypotenuse will be root of R square omega L whole thing square. So you know hypotenuse square is always equals to base square plus height square. So therefore hypotenuse will be equals to root of R square plus omega square L square, or you can say omega L whole thing square. So looking to this equations, what we read about cos of phi? Cos of phi will be equals to R by Z. So this is Z. Cos of phi is R by Z, and so you write here R as it is, and what is Z? Root of R square plus omega square L square. Similarly sine of phi will be from the equation number 5. So sine phi will be omega L by Z. Okay, so once again omega L divided by Z is actually the magnitude of vector Z. Okay, so what we read here, R square plus omega square L square. Simple mathematics. If sine is this, cos is this, so what will be tan phi? Sine by cos. Sine phi by cos phi. So, definitely it will be WL by R if you simplify these two equations. So, definitely phi angle, this angle. So, this angle will be equals to tan inverse of omega L by R. So, this we can write. Okay. Now, what substitution we have made? Using that substitution, equation number 3 can be written as. Equation number 3. What was 3? This is your equation number 3. Vector Z is equals to R plus J omega L. So, vector Z is equals to R plus J omega L. So, we put the values. Yes, see. What is R? It is Z into cos of phi plus J as it is. J as it is. And what is omega L? Z into sine of phi. Okay, vector Z. Make it very clear. Z and vector Z. This is the vector quantity and Z is its magnitude. So you can take Z common and in the bracket you can write here cos phi plus J into sine of phi. Vector Z. Or finally, you can write. You can write this thing. Yes, vector Z is equals to Z into e to the power J phi. So, this is your another equation. Equation number 6. Important equation. Equation number 6. Okay. So, actually, we want to find out the alternating current. We want to find out the alternating current in the LR circuit. And the equation is 2. So, here, I, alternating current, EMF and this is Z. Okay. So here I, here this here I will write here I will be, now I will be equals to E0 e to the power J omega T divided by vector Z. Rather you say this is 3A. So we put the values of vector Z in 3A. So putting the value of Z, putting the value of vector Z in equation 3A, we write what is 3A? Yes, I is equals to E0 e to the power J omega T divided by vector Z was there, so Z into e to the power J phi. Okay. Why we substituted the value of vector Z in equation number 3A? Because as you want to find out the alternating current. So this alternating current I is equals to E0 e to the power. Yes, this is Z. You can take this is in the numerator. Already there is omega T minus J phi. J is out of, yes, J we have taken out of the equation. So what I write here? What I write here, E0 divided by Z e to the power J omega T minus phi. Yes. We write here, alternating current is equals to E0 divided by Z, magnitude of vector Z, into e to the power J omega T minus phi. Here, the value of Z is I is equals to finally E0 e to the power J omega T minus phi, and what is Z? This is Z. So Z is the root of R square plus omega square L square. This is suppose equation number 7. Okay. This is equation number 7. twice twice tan inverse omega L by R. We know this. Okay. Now here look at the equation, look at this equation. From these equations some important points can be mentioned. You can say conclusion. What are the conclusion regarding the application of AC voltage source to LR circuit? What are the conclusions of application of AC voltage source to LR circuit? Number one, we can say what current is produced, alternating current is produced having the same frequency. So you can say F is equals to omega by 2 pi. Same is the frequency of the applied EMF. See, here there is omega. So what is the frequency of this applied EMF? Same, omega by twice pi. And because of that, what current is produced? That is also having only omega, so frequency is same. Okay, so alternating current produced in the LR circuit, it is also varies with the same frequency. And yes, again that alternating current varies with the sine angles, sinusoidal, sine of omega t minus phi. Second thing, as we always say, whatever the coefficient of sine, that is called as the amplitude. So number two, what is number two? Yes, the amplitude of the alternating current. Amplitude of alternating current. In which circuit? In LR circuit. Alternating current. How you decide the amplitude? Just the coefficient of sine. So that is E0 divided by root of R square plus omega square L square. Okay, then as I told you, the alternating current lags behind the applied EMF by phase phi. The alternating current, where in LR circuit lags behind the applied EMF. Applied EMF by phi, and how much is phi? As I mentioned here, tan inverse omega L by R. Okay. Look at the equation number 9 from equation number, you can say 9, we can get the magnitude of complex impedance. Magnitude of complex impedance. What is that? That is Z. So what will be Z? Z will be equals to, actually Z is root of R square plus omega square L square. Look at equation number 9, or look at this phasor diagram. This phasor diagram is very important. Remember everything from this phasor diagram. So this vector, Z, magnitude of complex impedance, which means vector Z, it should be equals to what we write here, E0 divided by I0. You know very well E0 is the maximum value of applied EMF and I0 is the maximum value of the alternating current in LR circuit. So you can write this thing as you know very well, this is actually root 2 into ERMS. Here root 2 into IRMS. So root 2 get cancelled. So E0 by I0, peak value of EMF divided by peak value of alternating current is always equals to RMS value of EMF divided by RMS value of current. Okay, so this is and last one this is z, so reciprocal of z, reciprocal of z is called the admittance, and it is denoted by y, so admittance of the LR circuit will be 1 by z. 1 by z means 1 by this root of r square plus omega square l square, or if you want to find out, this will be just reverse, irms divided by erms. So this is all about the fourth circuit of alternating current, that is what, application of AC voltage source to LR circuit, a circuit consisting resistor of resistance R and inductor of inductance L. So thank you for listening. I hope you will be benefited by these lectures, and in third video lectures we see another circuit, application of AC voltage source to CR circuit. So okay, thank you very much for listening. Thank you.